Formulas are extremely powerful in Coda because they actually help you understand your data or draw meaning out of all those rows inside of your table. What I'm going to show you in this next few minutes is how to write Coda formulas, but how to write meaningful ones that will help you build dashboards and tell stories about the data in your tables. Stick to the very end because I'm going to show you all the way from beginner to intermediate, master, all the way to insanity level formulas and how to do those simply with less clicks. So let's go. All right, first to set the context, I have a table here of opportunities. This is like a sales CRM, so these are companies that we're trying to sell to. There's different aspects in this CRM opportunity table, like source, where it came from, the stage of the deal, the priority, the deal amount, and when these were created. All of these different columns are gonna help us filter and understand our data in different ways. So let's go ahead here and start with beginner. And again, just to clarify, I am doing this with an opportunities table, but what you're gonna learn in this video, there are common formulas and concepts that you can apply to any Coda table that you have. So let's start with our beginning level formulas. How many leads are in our pipeline? We just want to know how many rows there are. One way I could do it is scroll to the bottom and see that there are 48, but obviously I don't wanna have to scroll to the bottom every time to recheck that number. I want a formula that will draw that out. How I could do that is click into the canvas here and press the equal button. The equal button on my keyboard will bring up my formula editor. And now I can start, you'll see here opportunities, it's showing what's inside of my document. I'll do opportunities and I can just say dot, that period or that dot is really important in Coda formulas. I'm gonna say dot count. That will give us just 48 opportunities. Because it is a formula, if I add one more opportunity down here, 49, you'll see that that instantly updates to 49. All right, so that's a beginner way of how we write formulas. We're gonna progressively get a bit more complex as we go. Next off is how many total retainers have we had in our pipeline? Down here, we have deal type and we have some that are retainers. I want to know how many retainers there are. One way I could do it, of course, I could group it along the left. I could collapse all of these groups and I could see that we have 12 retainers. I don't want to do that manually. We're going to do that with a formula. Press equals on our keyboard. I'm going to say opportunities.filter. Filter is one of the most common formulas you will use in Coda. Memorize it, get comfortable with it. We're going to filter where the deal type is equal to a retainer. That's going to give us a list of the rows that are retainers, but we want to know how many. So let's add a dot count to the end of that. And now we have 12 retainers. Those are our beginner formulas. We're going to move to the next stage, intermediate. We want to know how many leads are active in our pipeline. Obviously here, if we go and ungroup this, we have a stage and we have ones that are stalled, passed on, we didn't act, some that are ghosted and lost, need more information. We wanna know how much are actually active. So what we could do is we could say, again, opportunities.filter for where the stage, and then we can say is in, and now we can start listing off the different stages that are active for us. So we can say, well, stalled is technically active. Revival is active. Let's keep going to consultation track, they're active. And let's look on new. So for example, now you'll see we're getting a lot more, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We've got 5, we're gonna dot count that at the end. But that's actually difficult. I'm gonna show you an easier way to do that without having to list off every single one. So this is actually a Coda trick. What you can do with your stage select list column is turn it into, if you go edit column, turn this, scroll to the bottom of all the options and convert it to a table. When you do that, we'll call it stages below current table, we'll create it. Let's scroll down now and you'll see here, these are all our stages. We can actually create a new column that is a checkbox and that column will show us if it is active. This will make it number one, a lot easier to write our formula. And number two, it's gonna make it a lot easier over time to manage this if this grows more often, right? If it, our stages, the number of them grow, we don't wanna have to go into that formula and update it every time. So we're gonna now just check what is technically active. We're gonna say that one, revival, consultation track, new, need more meeting, scoping, discovery, and contacted. You'll now see that we can go back to our formula and we can actually, instead of this whole stages in deal, we can just say stage dot is active. equal to true. So there we go. That's 15 that we have active. And you can see that automatically update because if we take our consultation track and we call that non-active, we scroll back up, you'll see that now it's at 14. If we consultation back, we'll now see that there are 15 active leads. Let's keep going. They're going to get harder as we go. How many leads have come in during the last 60 days? Once again, opportunities.filter. You'll see in almost everyone we're using filter. Get really comfortable with that formula. We want to know where the created on is greater than or equal to today. Today is a great formula in Coda. It's always going to pull the current day's date. So I'll just say today minus 60. Dot count. There we go. 8 leads in the past 60 days. Again, I have a created on here, and you could actually get a created on column inside your Coda document by simply coming to this T here, column type, search created, and you'll see created on, and that will bring you that column type, and you can use that to understand, you know, how fast things are coming through. All right, so that's beginner and intermediate level. They're only going to get harder as we go. What is the most common lead source in the last 60 days? So here's another one. Lead sources, I've got Simpadox, Twitter, webinars, referrals, and more. I want to know in the last 60 days, what's our most common lead source? Instead of having to actually ask that or scroll through or figure that out manually, we're going to press equals. We'll say opportunities.filter for where the created on is greater than or equal to today minus 60. So first, just like we did before, we find out the ones that are that came in the last 60 days. Then we're going to take from that list of items, we are going to take the source. Yep. And then from the sources, you'll see here, if I do this, it says Simpadox, YouTube, Twitter, Simpadox, website, return client, referral, YouTube. So what I can do here is I can say mode comes most often. That returns Simpadox website as the most common in the last 60 days. There will be, we'll see there actually, if I, let's do a bulleted list. There's 2 Simpadox web types, 2 Twitters, and 2 YouTubes. So technically many of them are the most common. There are some other ways we can get that most common. I'm going to show you how to do something similar to that in the insanity level. We'll get there in a bit. All right. Next up, list the 5-star leads over 50,000 in revenue that are still active. So you'll notice that we're layering on criteria, right? We've got 3 criteria: 5 stars, over 50,000, still active. So once again, we're just going to layer 3 different filter or criteria inside of our filter. So opportunities.filter for where the priority is equal to 5. I could say greater than or equal to 5, but I don't have any that are over 5. I know that. I could actually say opportunities to check, opportunities.priority.max. So I know the highest priority is 5. So let's go back and we'll filter for where the priority is equal to 5. And we'll just type the word and. And expected revenue. Deal amount. Deal amount is greater than or equal to 50,123. Notice that I'm not putting a comma in between there. As you type numbers and formulas, you shouldn't put a comma there. Just kind of weird. So we're going to say, and again, still active. We'll say stage dot is active is equal to true dot count. All right, we're going to return nothing, but we'll see this 0. That's not good, right? So let's go actually change one. This one is over 50,000. That one is stalled. We'll take it and turn it to need more meetings. Oh, they're not 5. We got to make them 5. Yep. Still 0. Let's make them priority 5. Boop. And instantly that turns to 1 lead. All right. That's great. We can actually not count it too. If we don't want to count it, we could show, okay, cool. Look, woo, here it is. This is the one we're looking at right there. Why does it say Steven? That's because of the display column. Let's turn this to the display column. And now it will show you which lead it is. We've got 2 more to go. Got to get to the last one. List our top 3 active deals by potential deal amount. So here we go. This is going to be fun. We're going to actually give you a list. This will really help you start building dashboards once you master formulas like this. First, let's get some coffee. Top 3 active deals by potential deal amount. Let's say opportunities dot sort. So first, I'm going to take this whole list and sort them. We want to sort it false. False makes it descending. but we're going to choose what we sort by. We're going to sort it by the deal amount. So now we have the 48. We got 48 different ones, right? I can dot count it to show myself. Notice that I'm looking down here. It says 48. It's giving me a preview of what I'm going to come up with. That helps me write good formulas. But I know that there's 48 and they're now sorted by the deal amount. I don't want all of them. I just want the top three. So I'm going to use a formula called slice, which just gets a part of a list. So I don't want the whole list. I just want a part. That's what slice is going to do for us. I want to start at one and end at three. And then I'm going to do a numbered list. Now I can see our top three active deals by potential deal amount. Ooh, these aren't active yet. Let's move one more. We're going to say instead of opportunities.sort, we're going to say .filter for where stage.isActive. There we go. So now we've got the active deals. I can see that this is in the discovery meeting stage. And let me go hover that over that again, right? This is the discovery meeting stage and its deal amount is 98,000. One vision is stalled, but we call that active and they are in the $87,000 range. Sticking with this last one. This is gonna be probably the craziest formula you've ever seen on Coda. But I'm going to show you afterwards actually how to write it without a formula as well. Let's go. All right. So what lead sources have the highest average deal amount? Across my different lead sources, right? There's a good amount of them. I want to know which one have the highest amount, average deal amount. So let's start our formula and say opportunities dot source dot unique. What that is going to do is you'll see here, those gives us the unique sources, right? Simpadoc's website, Twitter, webinars, referral, Coda community, experts program, YouTube, and return client. All right. So what we're going to do there is we're going to run a formula over these called for each. If you don't know what the for each formula is, I have a whole video that goes over it. So go look for that, the Coda guy, for each formula. But what it does is it just runs a loop. So there are, if there's eight different sources, this is going to run a formula eight different times. But first we're going to take the current value again, go watch my for each video if you haven't gotten that yet. And we're going to give it a name. That name is going to be, we use the formula let to give something a name. I'm going to call that the current, source in loop. Then what we're going to do is we're going to say opportunities dot filter for where the source is equal to the current source in the loop. And then for each of those, we're going to say current value dot let. We're going to use that one more time. We're going to call that the current bunch. No, actually, I don't want the current bunch of items. Let's do something different. Instead of taking the source as current formula loop. So hopefully you're seeing right now, formulas are an art. We're having to think through them. Even myself, I'm having to think through this as we're going through live. I think we're actually going to take the deal amount dot average. Here we go. And then we're going to, for each one of those, I'm going to call the current value. You can see that has a little dollar sign on it. We're going to call that let current bunch average. And now we should be able to format. We should be able to write 1, 2. Format helps us get texts in there. What we're going to do here is we're going to say the current source in the loop and the current bunch average. And I think I have an extra one of these. There we go. And now dot numbered list. Yes. All right. So what this gives us now is it gives us the Simpadoc website is on average, we've gotten 55,000 per deal for it. Twitter, we've got on average $73,000 per deal that has come in. So this is a much more advanced formula. It's actually writing a nested for each loop. We're naming our variables and then we're formatting the output. A lot is going on here. Don't worry if you can't write a formula like this. There's actually an easier way to get this answer with just a couple clicks and no formulas. So let me show you that last thing. How you can do this instead, and we can even verify our answers, is actually turn your table into a chart. So if I come over to this table and click over options, I can see all options and I can take this from a table to a chart. Now on my chart setup, I can choose the source. I'll choose the deal amount as my value and I'll choose its average. You can now see here that if I hover over a Coda community, my average deal amount is $87,500. If I go here, $87,500. If I go to Twitter, we're at $73,000. Twitter is at $73,000. So via this formula, I'm grabbing the same data that I am down here, but in chart form. This is much harder to write. This is much easier, but this might be better for some different dashboards or scenarios. So it's important to know how to do both. Got any questions about the formulas we wrote? Put them in the comments below.